Hello everyone, welcome to the channel Tutor Box. In today's class, I am going to discuss about the answers of 16 questions which I given in clinical trial introduction lecture. So the first question is, phase 0 clinical trials are also known as. So the correct answer of this question is microdosing trial. Question number second, mostly how many participants enroll in phase 0 clinical trials? So I discussed already all participants in the phases. So the correct answer is 10 to 15 persons. Question number 2, mostly how many participants enroll in phase 1 clinical trial? So the correct answer is 20 to 80. Question number 4, healthy volunteers enroll in which clinical trial? A, phase 0, B, phase 1, C, phase 2, D, phase 3. So the correct answer is A and B, phase 0 and phase 1. In both of these trials, healthy volunteers are participating. In phase 0, particularly cancer patient also participating. But according to this question, the phase 0 and phase 1 both are correct. Question number 5. In majority of cases, targeted medical condition, volunteer enrolled in which clinical trial? So again, options are phase 0 to phase 3. Okay. So the correct answer of this question is C and D. Okay. Phase 2 and phase 3. Clear? Question number 6. In majority of cases, efficacy is measured in which clinical trial? So again, all of these options are given. So the correct answer is C and D. Phase 2 and phase 3. Question number 7. Mostly how many participants enroll in phase 3 trial? So phase 3 trials are bigger trial. So almost 1000 to 3000 people are participating in these trials. Question number 8. Phase 0 trial generally use which dosing? So I already told you that in phase 0 trial we are using 100 microgram dosing. Question number 9. Generally duration of phase 3 trial remain. Okay, so phase 3 trial are generally for a longer duration. So several years is the correct answer. Question number 10. Generally duration of phase 4 trial remain. So generally phase 4 trial are ongoing or for several years we can say, because after FDA approval these trials are regularly conducted by any of the organization. That's why the answer is ongoing. Question number 11. Phase 4 trial determines A, pharmacoeconomics, B, epidemiological data, C, both of these, and D, none of these. So correct answer is both of these. Question number 12. Phase 1 trial generally chooses which study design? So phase 1 trial chooses unblinded and uncontrolled trial. Clear? Question number 13. Factors to be identified in phase 3 trial. So drug disease interaction, B, drug interaction, C, doses interval, D, all of these. So the correct answer is all of these. Question number 14. Phase 2nd trial generally chooses which method? A, placebo control comparison, B, active control comparison, C, both of these, and D, none of these. So the correct answer is both of these. Question number 15. Mostly how many participants enroll in phase 4 clinical trial? So we all know that several thousand people enroll in these clinical trials. Question number 16. When phase 4 clinical trial conducted? So after FDA approval to marketing the drug, B, before FDA approval to marketing the drug, C, during phase 3 trial process, D, none of these. So the correct answer is after FDA approval to marketing the drug. So I hope you people are able to understand all of these. Already I given the all explanation of these question in my earlier lecture. So you can go through with that lecture of clinical trial comparison and see the playlist of pharmacovigilance lecture for more details in various pharmacovigilance lectures. I hope you people able to understand all of these. If you think this MCQ are useful, then share this MCQ to various groups. Jai Bharat, Jai Hind.